Hey folks, I'm Andrew Szeto. We're here at my workshop here in Wakefield, Quebec. And today we're gonna build one of these. Paddle made with recycled skateboards. Got all sorts of types of wood in it. And yeah, it's just a staple of mine. Super fun to make and you'll look amazing on the river. So let's go for it. So right now we're inside of my small little humble 200 square foot shop and we're gonna make one of these. Like we mentioned, it's the recycled skateboard paddle. And as said in the name, we of course have to start with some recycled skateboards first. And so here is sort of our raw materials right here. A couple broken skateboards from our community. Just as a bit of background, you know, I've grown up as a skateboarder in the Ottawa area, and yeah, it's just been sort of one of my life passions. So to kind of bring them back to life and kind of use a medium that's really important to me is a fun way to kind of give back and, you know, kind of make some beautiful products. For folks looking to get into using recycled skateboards, they can go to the local skate shops, you know, they can talk to their friends who might have broken or old decks and stuff. And if you're a skateboarder, you can use, you know, your personal collection and stuff from the past. So, you know, all sorts of ways of getting the material, and oftentimes it's free, and yeah, you can just, with a little bit of elbow grease, you can get into it. So, with regards to what we actually do to process the skateboards, first of all, we have to use a heat gun. The heat gun, you apply some heat so that the adhesives on the grip tape kind of make it easier for it to peel off. And then after the grip tape's kind of been peeled off, you have some grip tape gunk, some adhesive that's left over. So how you deal with that is you use a grinder. A grinder with a cuts all sanding disc, you can apply that to the board itself and that'll usually take off most of the gunk. Once the gunk is gone, I usually like to pass a palm sander over top of it just to ensure that we have some consistency in the wood. And then yeah, we basically have some material that's ready to be used. Cool, so at this point, with the skateboard fully ready, we've kind of cut the noses and tails off of the middle section of the board in between all the holes for the hardware. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut off 1-inch strips. We're gonna use a crosscut sled with 1-inch marked off. So we kind of have a stop block there. And we're basically gonna make passes on the table saw and make a whole bunch of 1-inch strips that we'll glue together. So with several 1-inch strips cut together, these basically will be the accent pieces of the paddle itself. We have to glue them together. I kind of like to glue them in sections of 4 and then prepare them furthermore on the table saw. So just to glue up, I use a little bit of tight bond, kind of glue this all together. And then using some C-clamps, we'll basically clamp it away. And so with this glued up now, we'll leave this for 24 hours. So we've got some pieces now of the skateboards that are jointed and planed. They're ready to go in terms of being able to shape them now for the paddle. So what we do is we actually have this 45 degree angled jig that I use on my table saw. And then I'll basically cut out the skateboards into sections that'll fit into my glue up jigs for the paddle blades themselves. So prepping this, the first cut I'll just kind of make to cut off some excess here just so that we kind of have this 45 degree angle. This is just so that it fits well with the rest of the paddle once we kind of have it together. We'll cut off 3-inch sections that'll all fit in the jig itself. So that was 2 sets of these skateboard strips that were glued together that were cut up on the table saw. So as you see now, they kind of fit into this 45 degree angle jig that I have for the paddle blade glue up itself. I've kind of carefully picked out the colors so that they kind of have cool coordinating colors and they kind of match on one side and the other. We put it together like a bit of a puzzle here. With the skateboards now cut and put into the jig itself, we need to fit it in with the rest of the types of wood. I usually like to use contrasting types of wood, so I usually like a nice walnut, which is a nice darker wood. And then in this case, for today, we're using a red oak, which is a request from a customer and stuff. So we'll kind of be able to use the same 45 degree angle jig and kind of cut off sections that kind of fit into various sections so that we have some nice contrast between the various types of wood. And yeah, we'll have a beautiful paddle at the end of that. So as we kind of just cut there, we're gonna throw in a little bit of walnut, a little bit of red oak. Skateboards are already there, a little more walnut. a little bit of red oak, and we kind of have a paddle. You can kind of effectively see what it's going to look like here. So similar to gluing the four strips together, we kind of break out our tight bond again and kind of start gluing the sections together. Pull everything out of the jig, slowly insert it. For the backing paper, I've just kind of got, I've cut up grocery bag. So just kind of use whatever I have available to me. Glue in the sections together. And this is Type Bond 3 that I'm using. Type Bond 3 is the more waterproof of the Type Bonds. So it's pretty sweet for this particular application, I find. It's like that with glue on everything. It's basically time to throw down a pipe clamp over top just to ensure that everything clamps really nicely and tightly. And yeah, we leave that for 24 hours and we will have blades ready to be put together into a paddle. So while we got the paddle blades glued up, that's gonna take about 24 hours for them to get ready. And right now I have some paddle blades here that are already together. This particular pattern is called the Chevron pattern. So it's a little different from the ones that we've been making thus far. They're just proprietary patterns that, you know, I've kind of have fun making and stuff. First and foremost is to take them out of the jigs themselves. So with the blades now intact, the next part is to have some clean edges on there. And what I've got is another jig for the table saw, a jig with two sets of toggle clamps that we'll be able to secure the blades down with. And then with a runner on the bottom, we'll be able to run it through the table saw and just kind of give us those nice clean edges to work from. So at this point, what we're doing is we're gonna cut a dado into the blades themselves. It has to go about an inch deep. That's gonna provide a lot of rigidity in the paddle itself because we'll put a spline that connects the paddle blade to the stem itself. And it's gonna go about an inch deep on the paddle itself and then about a half inch on the stem just to make everything rock solid. And it'll all be connected with epoxy. So it's all waterproof on the inside as well. So what I've done here is I've set the table saw. So it's about a half inch off the fence itself and about 1 inch tall. Just because our material, if you recall, the strips themselves were about an inch. So coming in about half inch gives us nice amount of material on either side of this particular dado and on the spline once it's all constructed. Okay, so at this point we've got dados cut out in our stem. We've also got the dados cut out in our blades themselves. So what we're now gonna do is we need to cut out a set of splines, and that's basically the 1/8 inch piece of plywood that kind of goes in between, connecting everything together. So I've got my 1/8 inch piece of plywood, and I'm gonna cut it 1.5 inches thick so that it's gonna go in between both the stem and the paddle blade itself. So at this point, we've got everything cut up. We have our blades assembled. We have our splines ready to attach everything. So it's time to mix up some epoxy and start just getting glue onto every piece to start piecing together. Super important, I like to wear gloves. Definitely don't wanna get epoxy on your hands. I usually wear a respirator too, just so I'm not smelling any of the fumes coming off the epoxy. So at this point, we've kind of got everything glued up. You know, we've done all the blades themselves. We've put everything together with epoxy. So here's effectively our blank that we're gonna shape into a beautiful paddle. I've got a trusty paddle that I've made before in the past. I love this particular shape. It's kind of a more streamlined beaver tail design that I love making. So we're gonna trace that onto this today. and we're gonna cut it out in the bandsaw. Yeah, so you just throw it over top, ensure that your stems are aligned, and you just start tracing away. So we'll take it down in size with a power planer, and then afterwards we can refine the shape with a belt sander. So this is really just to give us a rough shape for now. Beautiful. Okay, so at this point we're outside. This is where we do all my shaping because it gets a little nasty in terms of just, you know, wood flying everywhere and stuff. So at this point, we're gonna be using the power planer to take off a majority of our excess wood here on the paddle to really shape it down. We'll be using a router to shape the stem itself so that it kind of give everything a nice round over. And then we'll use a belt sander to kind of just really finesse it even further and really come up to our final shape there. So. Yeah, this is the process. So at this point, we're sort of at the halfway phase where we've kind of really shaped it down with the power planer and the router. So I've retraced the shape onto the paddle, and now we're gonna hit everything else with the belt sander and be able to really pare it down to its final shape. So at this point, we have it pretty much sanded down. And what we would do from here is we'd pretty much add 4 coats of epoxy, sanding in between each coat to ensure that it's even, and also that, to ensure that the paddle itself is waterproof pretty much for its lifetime. So that in a nutshell is the process of going from recycled skateboards to fun, beautiful products like these paddles that I've made. And yeah, I hope they inspired you a little bit. Feel free to reach out to myself on either Instagram or YouTube or any of the socials should you want to find out more. And yeah, all the best in your making, and peace out from myself, Spence, Atlas, and yeah, happy making.
Did you get tangled? What happened?